thanks to your support. And now, welcome for all of you for 76th meeting. I guess 76 it is. Okay. And I want to welcome a guy who is very energetic, enthusiastic. Even though sometimes he commits, he can't able to match it up because of his commitment. But his commitment always very good. And this is the first time he is taking this role. And welcome, Presiding Officer Toastmaster Adityan Kumar.
Good evening, fellow Toastmasters and guests. With all your permission, I will start the 76th meeting of SpeakMagic Toastmasters in online. Ralph C. Midley was started the Toastmasters on October 22nd, 1924 at the YMCA Santa Ana, California, United States. It's originated as a set of classes with aim improving communication skills and young men under his age under Californian law by December 19, 1932. Toastmasters teaches you how to become an effective communicator and leader. It also helps in some of the areas which are being more effective communicator, improving the grammar and vocabulary, exercising the time management, and always we will find the time and will be at the time. And being a great listener and positive on the specific helpful feedback we can give and speaking to inspire others. These are all the main characteristics we attain by attending the Toastmasters meeting. With all this session, the Toastmasters meeting will be of three sets. First will be a prepared speech, where it follows by a table topic session. And after this, we will get an evaluation feedback. So, for a wonderful and enthusiastic Toastmaster meeting, we need a MC, right? For that, we are having a great, intelligent and corporate employee. He will be taking us all through the coronavirus and disasters we are facing it now. With all your presence, I welcome Toastmaster Michael, who will be the Toastmaster of the day for the 76th meeting. Toastmaster Michael.
Thank you. Thank you, the presiding officer. Very good evening, fellow Toastmasters and guests. How are you all doing?
Good evening.
Fine.
Great to hear you people. And I'm really, really happy to have this meeting in a virtual time for the first time. How many of you like rhymes? How many of you like or love rhymes? I see Anandra's answers.
Because I'm teaching you.
Even I am.
Even you like Ramesh also. Oh, great. So, what do you have any favorite rhymes, Ramesh? Anything
Wash
favorite?
Beer.
Okay.
Wash
now,
Anand,
for you.
Johnny, yes, Papa. That's the famous one which I am.
Johnny, yes, Papa. Okay. That is a rhymes which we all used to have played during our childhood, where we used to form a group in a circle and we used to circle and play our rhymes. How many of you remember that rhymes?
Ringa Ringa Roses.
Ringa Roses.
Yes. So, can somebody sing that song for me? Okay, let's join together and sing, okay?
Yes.
Ringa Ringa
Roses.
Pocket full of roses.
Hasha.
Bush.
Fall down.
Great. A great round of applause for everybody, okay? So, this rhymes is looking so great and it creates a happy mood today. But what is the history behind this rhymes? That is something which is literally shocking. So when we go back in the history, in 13th century, 13th and 14th century, there was a disease called Black Plague. So there were nearly 40,000 people died because of it. And in that mood, this rhymes was written. So the Ringa Ringa Roses means it points to the round red color rashes that comes because of plague. Pocket full of poisons in the sense. It refers to a herb that is used to cure the plague at that point. Hasha in the sense. Hasha busha in the sense. It's just referring to the sneezing, one of the symptoms of the black plague. We all fall down in the sense. We are eventually dying. That was the mindset of the poet when he wrote this. And today, we are celebrating this rhymes very happy to. Ladies and gentlemen, there's no, if you need a peaceful and non-challenging life that is not on the surface of soil, it always lies inside the surface of the soil. Ever since humankind has evolved, it has faced so many challenges. And challenge is not something new for any humankind. Our humankind is very successful enough in breaking all these challenges and making this earth a great peaceful place to live in. So with this mindset, I want everybody of you to travel into this meeting. Let's have a very optimistic mindset, which is really required for this space in throughout the world. Let's spread the optimism. So that, with that note, I wanted to get into the meeting today. And when VP requested me to give the theme of the day, I said the theme of the day should be disaster. Man, he said, like, obviously he should say, why disaster? Michael, you are negative. So I said, like, I don't want to be negative. Let's have the theme of the day be like, disaster is a wonder in disguise. Always. Unless a thorn was got into hurt a human legs, there was nothing called slippers are designed. So only when a disease comes in, we are taking care of our health and the world is looking out for a solution. We always need problems to reach our fullest potentials. So that is how we treat the problems and challenges across the world. So disaster is nothing but it's really a wonder in the disguise. And word of the day today seems to be catastrophe. Catastrophe again points to a disaster, which a grammarian will really explain it. So today, our 76th meeting of SpeakMagic Toastmasters is going to have three sessions. So first session will be the prepared speech session, where we have a wonderful lady speaker to speak on. And second session will be a table topics, the most exciting session. And third one will be the evaluation session. So any Toastmaster meeting has its complete essence on evaluation. So to conduct that evaluation part, we have our general evaluator today. This man, he's really very young to Toastmaster, maybe like 4 or 5 months, but the energy and the learning he has done in this 4 or 5 months is really a big. Ladies and gentlemen, let's put our hands together for Toastmaster Silvaraj, general evaluator of the day. Over to you, Silva.
Hi, everyone. Welcome to the first online meeting. It was so nice, good experience for us. The first time now we are conducting this meeting online, and this gives a lot of energy, enthusiasm, and it also saves a lot of time. And we are all connected from different parts of Chennai, and it is really nice. Many times we would have missed out Mr. Ramesh, Toastmaster Ramesh. Today is here, so I'm so great. I'm as a general evaluator, I will evaluate the meeting from start till end of the meeting, and I will produce the report towards the end. I cannot do this on my alone. So I have a tag team today. Okay. The timer is the Toastmaster Ramesh, and today's our counter is the Toastmaster Andaraj. Please welcome to join welcoming Toastmaster Ramesh as a timer. Over to Ramesh.
Thanks, Toastmaster Silvaraj. As a timer, I will evaluate, notify all the times, and when called upon by the general evaluator, I will inform to that. For the prepared speech, it will be 5 to 7 minutes. For 5 minutes, I will show the green signal. For 6 minutes 30 seconds, I will show the yellow signal, and 7 minutes, I will show the red signal, which means the speaker has to wrap up within 30 seconds. For table topics, the allowed time is 1 to 2 minutes. For 1 minute, I will show the green signal. For 1 minute 30 seconds, I will show the yellow signal. at 2 minutes, I'll show the red signal, which means that speaker has to wrap up within 30 seconds. For evaluation, the time will be 2 to 3 minutes. For 2 minutes, I will show the green signal. For 2 minutes, 30 seconds, I will show the yellow signal. For three minutes, I will show the red signal, which means the evaluator has to wrap up within 30 seconds. At the end of the report, at end of the meeting, I will give my report to the general evaluator. Over to you, Selvaraj.
Thanks, Toastmaster Ramesh, for explaining the role of the timer. Next, we have our counter. Our counter today is Toastmaster Anandaraj, who is an young, energetic person who is who regularly attends our meeting, and he is the one who traveled to US and South Africa. He is having two sweet daughters. Let us welcome Toastmaster Anandaraj to explain the role of our counter.
Thank you, Toastmaster Silva. Today I'll be a counter for this Toastmaster meeting, SpeakMagic Toastmaster meeting of 76. So I'll be noting down the uses of words, uses of a, and filler words. I'll submit the report end of the meeting. Over to Toastmaster Silva.
Thanks, Toastmaster Anandaraj. I'm not sure who is taking up the grammarian role today, and already Toastmaster today, Mike, explained the word of the day is Cassatro, and I'll encourage all the speakers to use the word of the day. Whenever the speaker is using the word of the day, please on the chat window type something like a clap, or we can say I five. So that will boost up and we can have a counter with that. Okay. And we do have a speech evaluator that I will introduce during my evaluation session. I'll hand over the meeting again to Toastmaster of the day. Toastmaster Mike. Over to Mike, Toastmaster Mike.
Thanks, General Evaluator. It was really a great explanatory session. So, one question to the group. So, how you people will react when you are put into a catastrophic moment? So, today, we are almost like, how many of you feel like you are arrested in home? Not able to make any movements. Everybody. I remember for persons like Tamil or somebody, you cannot even think them. I think this is after a long time she's staying at home. That is the reason she's feeling it. So, Corona, there are like people are saying few precautions, okay? What are the precautions in the sense they say, like, wash your hands very frequently, don't sneeze without kerchief and everything. So that is one case, okay? Like for a person like Tamil or whoever, like feeling his house arrest, what precaution should we give them? Like, because if they are at home, they'll die soon. So we have to give them something good, right? So what should we do them, ask them to do? How many of you have got some books recently, but you never had a time to open it? I did it. Because my mom who sold the Ferrari is still not finished, and the Greatness Guide, it's still not finished. And if you're a movie freak, you still can go to Amazon Prime, okay? Amazon will never shut down, man. Even Corona goes to Amazon office also, they are not going to shut down. So go to Amazon Prime, watch as many number of movies and enjoy it. So these are some of the precautions to keep you mentally fit. Okay, so these are provided at free of cost. You need not pay me. Now let's get on to the next important session, that is prepared speech. So today we have a great eminent speaker, Tamil Ilakkiya, to present a project from Advanced Communication Goal, sell a product. So before I call Tamil to stage, I would like to hear from her, Satish Ganapathy, her speech objectives. Satish, over to you.
Thank you, Toastmaster, for today. So Toastmaster Tamil Ilakkiya is going to attempt a speech from the Advanced Communication Series manual, which is Speciality Speeches. So in this, she is going to attempt project number 3, which is to sell a product. The specific objectives of this project is for her to understand the relationship of sales techniques for persuasion, and then skillfully use the four steps in a sales presentation, which are attention, interest, desire, and action. And she also has to identify and promote a unique selling proposition in a sales presentation. And she should be able to handle objections and close a prospective buyer. So this is the project, and the time limit is 10 to 12 minutes. Minimum time limit is 10 minutes. Intermediate will be 11 minutes, and the final upper limit is 12 minutes. So these are the objectives. All the best, Toastmaster Tamil.
Over to you, Tamil.
Are you an aspiring public speaker who's looking to win the hearts of your audience and trophies of your contest? Then I have a product for you. Are you a parent of smart children who often to look forward to learn from you? Then I have a product for you. Are you recently hitched like our TMOD, Michael, or a person who's always in relationship like our presiding officer, Adi? Then I have a product for you. Good evening, fellow Toastmasters and distinguished guest like Ramya. I was a Toastmaster for the past 5 years. In the first year of my Toastmasters, I have delivered 10 speeches from the Competent Communicator Manual. And I received this, a Competent Communicator Certificate. After that, I felt I was struck. I couldn't move ahead in the communication path. You know why? Just because I've exhausted all the experience, all the stories that I had in my life. And in the Advanced Communication series, I was expected to use an anecdote or a story in every other speech I deliver. But I was left with no stories, no experience, no incident. I felt like a loser. I was disappointed, dejected, and devastated. At that point of time, something happened to me. I found an important object that helped me discover the important aspect of my strength. The product is this book called Storytelling Manual from Toastmasters International. You know why? Before that, let me ask you a question. Toastmaster Selvaraj, when you prepare a speech for your lovely daughter, how many times you surf internet and find stories?
So to answer the question, my daughter, she will prepare a story. I will just write a conclusion. It is something like, whatever it comes for her creativity, she will come, she will deliver as a story. For that story, I'll just write a conclusion. For writing a conclusion alone, I'll go and search in the internet. So it is something like in the story, it is something like, it is made up of her. And conclusion alone, I'll struggle a lot to correlate with that story and then present it. That is the problem at the moment. Apart from that, we do had got some kind of a clear idea, something on how to do this vocal variety and body language from your session, which you have done in our club. So let it go. That parent story also, it inspired a lot. And then she also explained the same scenario in her life. So for me, okay, story is something like she can, on her own experience, she's picking up. And from Toastmaster meeting, we are getting many stories.
Great. That's great to know that your daughter is already very creative. She knows how to cook up a story or how to imagine and develop a story out of nowhere. But we grown-ups are not sometimes that creative like the children, and especially me, I couldn't find a story or an anecdote when I have to speak about something. I often go to internet, take some stories and develop it, deliver it. But you know, unfortunately, the speaker just before me also uses the same story from the same website that I got. How awful it is to see somebody else using the same story as yours. Anybody of you had that experience? Got a story that is not at all fresh, not at all new, that is available for everybody to use? Looks like I'm the only one. Anyway, when you start delivering your speech, I think you will come across this situation. That is when I got this manual, storytelling manual. It has 5 storytelling techniques. Starts with folktale. How many of you read folktales? Or how many of you tell folktales to your children? No hands?
Tamil, okay. What is folktales?
Folktales in the sense, the stories from our ancestors. The stories that are told in village or something happened in the past. Even folktales are from our mythology or from our own the ancestors past. Something happened in the history or some beliefs like crow and vada story that we say, no, that party vada sutta kadai. Those are all folktales. So how many of you have the habit of narrating a story to your children? Bedtime stories. Every father would have that experience, right? The first project in this manual is a folktale. If you are someone like me who has no creativity, who rely on anything to speak about, then the first project is especially for you. It teaches how to deliver a story from the internet or from anywhere with a lot of life in it. You got to use vocal variations, expressions, all these. And this moves on to the personal story. The second project is personal story. You got to develop a story from your personal incident. And how many of you heard my story of the thrilling evening? I got caught by a cab driver and I felt lonely. Yes, that was a story that I developed after 2 years of my Toastmasters journey. After I struck after the competent communicator manual, thanks to this book, I was able to develop a story because it teaches how to develop a story with 5 important ingredients, right from characterization, plot setting, building it to climax, all these. So it talks about the 5 important steps in any story. If you just read it, you need not have any creativity. You just have to follow these 5 steps to create a story on your own. And then it moves on to a moral of the story, which is whatever story you cook up, you try to have a moral in it. And when you use a moral, your children listening to you or your audience listening to you feel like you are a hero. You're a star to them because you not only speak that is coming to your mind, you also try to develop their character. You're imparting an important message with them. And the 4th project is a touching story. Basically, a story that that moves somebody. How many of you watched the movie Nayagan or Guna? What is the message in Guna, if I ask you?
What is the message? We should focus on our goal, whatever the challenge we face.
Okay, thank you. We have to focus on our goals despite the challenges that lie ahead. I felt Kamal Hassan was very pure and he was spreading just love. He was not a negative person. He was very positive in his love. And I felt if somebody tells you just be positive or just move ahead with your goal and do not get disappointed with the obstacles that you face, how many of you would just like that accept it? But if we have a story, a love story with a hero, heroine, villains, songs, everything, that gives us a feel, right? That actually touches us. That actually moves us. When we see that movie or listen to that song, we feel like we have to become someone like Kamal Haasan to be unconditional in love, isn't it? That's the power of the story, my dear friends. If you just have a message told in a sentence, it will not impact the audience. That is where you need to touch the heart of your audience. So in this storytelling manual, there is a project for that as well. And finally, it is bringing history to life. We have everything in our history. How many of you heard my story of Rajaraja Solan giving away his throne to his heir? Great. How many of you liked it? Be honest. Thank you very much. And you know what? We have a lot that happened in the past that could be passed on to the next generation. But how many of you know how to say that, how to word it or narrate it in a way that children like it or their audience like it and adopt the viewpoint that we have to say? It's very challenging, I would say. So in this manual, we are taught to reword or recreate that moment happened in the history and to pass on the message to the next generation. You know what? I delivered only the first speech, the folktale, from this manual. After which, I did not know what happened. It gave a sense of fulfillment in me because of the appreciation I received from the audience. They liked me telling stories. Even some club like Toastmaster Selvaraj's Gavel Club even invited me to deliver a sports story because I was good at it. They felt I'm a good storyteller. Imagine your children are inspired just by listening to your words. They want to develop that storytelling art in them. What is the benefit of it? First of all, when you tell a story, your children listen to them and their listening skills improve. They just follow the father or mother word by word. Through your communication, their communication skills develop. Their grammar develop. Their vocabulary develop. Even they start writing stories, just like Ramya writing on her own. Their writing skills develop. And these are all developing in your children and in you and your audience. Overall, through your stories, you not just spread the message, you also empower the audience as well as your children along. And what I get or I got from this storytelling manual is this certificate, Advanced Communication Bronze. After 2 years of stuck between words and stories, I was able to finally complete 10 more speeches with 10 different stories that was created by me. Isn't it interesting?
Yes.
Thank you. And my dear friends, imagine you're in front of a thousands of audience in a world championship of public speaking stage. And you are narrating the story of your life, the story that made you come so far, that made you a successful person in your life. And everybody is applauding to you. A lot of people coming to you and asking for autograph. How do you feel? Awesome, isn't it? This will definitely happen if you have a book like this. If you know how to narrate your story in an interesting way to captivate your audience heart, you will definitely win the hearts of your audience and the trophies of the contest. If you have a book, Storytelling Manual from Toastmasters International, it's just $6, which is 454 rupees only. How many of you could buy this book? Ramya, do you need this book? Thank you very much. I have only 2 copies available right now. Those who want it online, I can send you online. It's just 5 rupees for today, an online copy. Please rush and register. I'll send you the copy immediately. Thank you very much.
Sure.
Yeah.
Are there any questions?
No.
To Toastmaster
of Bring. Ladies and gentlemen, let's put a big round of applause to Tamil. That was really a wonderful speech, right? So how should I personify your speech, Tamil? You're capable of convincing any crowd. It was really a great speech. And only thing which I'm very much worried about is the storytelling manual still a valid one in Toastmasters?
It's about learning the art of storytelling, not about filing it for educational awards. If you want to shape yourself as a storyteller or an aspiring public speaker to captivate your audience, then this is the magic formula.
In sales,
yeah, you
need not speak the entire truth. Right? The entire truth.
Their truth.
That it is not going to be valid after some time.
Oh.
Right? Then people will not buy.
Okay. No, it's about the skill. It's about the storytelling skills to captivate the audience. It's not about the certificate that you receive for an advanced communicator. One thing to tell you, you have ample of storytelling or story books available in the internet or in the market. But which of those will develop you as a storyteller? Which of you will make you a speaker? Only this book. Because this teaches you to be a storyteller, not just a narrator from an already written story. And those stories will be read by anybody else in the world. But your personal story, only you can tell. Am I right? And you have to know how to tell that in a way it is interesting to everybody. That's where the unique selling point of Toastmasters International come into place. It teaches you. It not just gives you a story to read. It teaches you how to be creative, how to be interesting. Any other questions? I think there is no question. Thank you very much. Over to Toastmaster of the Day.
Thank you. That was really a great speech, Tamil. It was inspiring. So I have to agree upon, not just me, everybody will agree upon this point. Storytelling manual is really, really one of the best manual which is available with PMI's traditional path. People who really wants to be a storyteller, it's your piece of cake. Go and grab it. Work on it. And again, practically speaking, it can even be related to some of the speeches and pathways. Try out it. And it was really a great speech, Tamil. So moving on to the next interesting session, that is table topics. So to pose this table topics, we have an evergreen lover boy of our club. He is known for this TTM sessions. Ladies and gentlemen, let's put our hands together for Toastmaster Adityan for conducting table topics. Over to you, Adi.
Good evening, fellow Toastmasters.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Good evening. Who will be the volunteer to speak for the table topics?
The latest joiner, Vidurar Venkatesh.
Latest joiner, he has joined.
Yes.
When was the last time you tried something new and it's just clicked and it succeeded? When was the last time you tried something new and just clicked and it succeeded? Vidurar Venkatesh.
He's lost.
Oh, you lost. Signal problem.
Could be.
Next, any volunteer?
Any other volunteers? Balasundar is coming in.
who do you sometimes compare to yourself and achieve the position of them? Who do you choose to compare to yourself and achieve as them?
Okay, thanks, Adi.
Yeah.
Okay. For me, it is always, can you hear me?
Yeah.
Good evening,
yeah.
Toastmasters and friends. Can you hear me?
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. Yes, it is always my boss, because I always respect them, and I always believe if I simply follow their orders, it will make everything, you know, successful in my team and my project. So always I compare myself with my boss and try to learn what is the one thing that made them or put them into this position and giving them everything. So that is one. And also inspire any elders in my home so that we can have a very good learning. And for my own belief, if we follow them blindly, definitely we'll get succeed. We don't need to do any research. We do not want to reinvent the wheel. We just to follow our seniors, whether it is a personal life or a corporate life, that will do. On top of that, if we apply anything on our own, that's well and good. But to make a simple life and a successful plan in our official life, just follow the seniors. That's the thing which I do in my life. I think, I don't know, the green card or orange card is coming. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you.
Go to Adi.
Next, any volunteers? Michael?
Okay, come on. You can give me.
What is your most beloved childhood memory?
What is my most beloved childhood memory? Okay, so I have many, man. So this one I have set in my icebreaker. Thing is, I think I was in third standard or something. So my mom actually left my grandparents' home. I was left under the custody of my neighbors, okay? So just next to our plot, there was one construction proceeding, okay? So they have digged up all the basements. And previous day was a rainy day. So what happened is the basement was nearly they have tried building a tank which was future to be used as a drainage. So the water was completely filled. So I had a childhood friend, her name is Aranya, okay. So she was I was playing with her, and unexpectedly she dropped her toy in that tank, okay. So it was a very light toy and it was floating on that water. So I was oh come on, how can I see a girl crying, man? Let's go and grab, help her through our heroism. That was my mindset. So what I did is I just tried to pull it up. It did not work out. Without even sensing the seriousness behind it, actually. So very later I was able to see my hands were up and it is rolling just like this, like Shakti Man. I'm hitting on the walls of the tank, and I can really picturize it now also. But suddenly a hand lifted me up. That was again my neighbor. So if you didn't have not done that on that day, I'm not here today. But I was saved from that tank. But later my mom came home and I cannot get it still now. My pains are still there with me. So that is one of my most heroic, memorable experience in my childhood. Happened at the age of 7. Over to you, the TTM.
Thank you. Next, any volunteers? Anyone willing to speak?
Vidurar.
Yes. Yeah. Same.
Yeah. Would you break the law to save your loved one?
Definitely not.
You have been a Toastmaster. Coronavirus is there. So due to it, you can't go outside. your loved one is in danger, how will you save her?
That is what I was trying to say. Table topic master, I will not break the rules, break the law. I will insist her and convince her that not to go out, because the rule is rule for common for everybody. So I thoroughly agree it. So I won't even take a second chance to it, to look through it, whether I should go out with her or whether can I go and spend a ample of time with her. Definitely not. The only word will come from my mouth is no. Shouldn't break the rules. That is what I suggest you all. Just don't go out. You may be having a good immune system, or you may be having a very good immune power to against the corona. As the government is ordered, please obey the rules. Not only as a friend, as a below Toastmaster, as a below member, I request you all to stay at home and fight against corona. So, table topic master, definitely not. No. Back to you.
Thank you. Next, anyone?
Who's the next volunteer?
Anandraj.
What's the topic, Adi? Anand Raj is ready.
No problem. Let him.
Okay.
So?
Yeah.
What gets you more excited? Any incidents, a sudden incident which strikes you more excited?
What gets me more excited? Good evening, fellow Toastmaster and guests.
Good evening.
When I got my first child, I got more excited. It's a new baby. So doctor has given to me in my hand. So when I looked at baby, I was more excited that it's a wonderful life for me as a family man. So really I was happy at that time. So that's my first excitement, which my in my career throughout life. So that is the excited one. Over to Adi.
Next, final topic. Anyone? Last topic.
Ramya wants to attempt.
Sure.
Ramya. Okay.
Great.
Ramya and Ramesh also wants to. So you can have two more topics.
Okay, Ramesh.
Yeah, okay. What gives you your life a meaning? What gives you a life meaning?
Topic for Ramya?
Yeah, topic for Ramya.
Okay. You want to talk this topic? Yeah. No. Otherwise, okay.
Change the topic.
Topic change.
Yes.
As a person, you can change the person. Yeah, give it to Ramesh.
Yeah,
Ramesh, you can talk on this. Ramesh.
Can you tell me one more time the topic? What?
What gives you a life meaning?
Okay, great. And start my timing. Good evening, fellow Toastmasters and guests. Whenever you are waking up in the morning, what is the thing comes to your mind? Do you have a exciting morning, or do you have a boring morning? Which makes you feel? What is your feel when you are waking up your morning?
Excited.
Excited morning.
Exciting, always.
Are you sure? 100%? After yeah, Sunday? Sure. Waking up on Monday?
Yeah, I don't want to go to office.
You don't want to go to office.
When you are having exited every morning, it feels that you are enjoying your journey towards to achieve your goal. Whenever you have something, basically, we have a desire to achieve that goal. But the problem is, we are not going in that direction. Whenever we have some failures, we are coming out of that direction. Basically, when you are... This is what the 99% of the people are doing it. But in my case, if you need to achieve anything, you have to... there is a little bit hard work and as well as a smart work. Both should be combined. Small everyday habits make you consistency. Have you ever heard about the compound effect? Compound effect. Anyone heard about it?
No.
Every day when you are trying to go with one step every day, one learning every day, throughout the end of the 365 days, it's not 365%. It is like 3,650%. That's how the compound effect works. So every day you have to do the habits which exacted you a lot. Thank you and over to you, Adi.
Yeah, next topic for Ramya. Ramya?
Yes.
Yeah, who do you love the most and why? Who do you love the most and why?
I love my Ramya? Family. Yes. I love my family. I love my friends. I love my family because my mother always cooks so much. And I love whatever she cooks. And my father always earns money. My sister plays with me. My friends also. Each and every single day I go to school, there's a smiling friend on the chat, waving to me. They all, it's just, they spread love just like that. Smiles spread every day. If you do a good deed, a smile comes upon another person's face. And smiles can spread everywhere. Everybody always is a beautiful person. Someone who loves you. I also like my class teachers who always teach me many things. Over to the table topic master.
Yeah, next, any volunteers? That's it.
Shall I try, Yadi?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I can't be able to hear, that's it.
No problem. Yeah. Now is it clear?
Yeah.
Yes, yes.
Yes. Yeah. I think we are connecting from laptop. And the mic is a problem.
Okay.
If
you had to teach, something, what would you teach? For the current scenario for Corona.
Okay. For the current scenario of the Corona, okay. Something like we have to accept whatever has happened, no, it's happened only. We cannot do anything, you know, out of our control. It is something now, it is an opportunity for other habitat, like the dolphin coming here to the shore. And the swan started floating on the lake. It shows that some change on the environment is required. So that is what it is teaching now at the moment. We have to give opportunity not only for human beings, even for other living things as well. So that is a great lesson we are learning at this point in time. And we are all now at the moment supposed to be at home. So now we can spend more time with the family. Is the learning we are getting from this Corona. It is something like, it is all whatever is happening, let us learn and then take it move forward. So instead of thinking why it happened, because this is nothing in our control. So all I learned only, we have to accept and move forward, and let us try to use the sanitizer.
It's a hand sanitizer.
Okay, let us try to use hand sanitizer. That is what I want to say. That's it. Thank you.
Thank you. Yeah, next anyone?
Bola, you can give it to your son or daughter.
Yes.
They're very
eager
for it.
Yes, give me a topic. I'll try.
Yeah, உங்களுக்காகவே எடுத்துச்சு மாதிரி இருக்கு.
Hey, speak in English.
What is the difference? Yeah, sorry. What is the difference between innocence and ignorance?
Hey.
Next topic.
No, I can talk about the same topic. When I hear the word innocence, again, Guna Kamala Hassan comes into my mind. You know, I think that he is very innocent. He is not knowing what is happening around, who are all, problematic guys. He goes and get caught between the villains, slaves, and, a lot of things happening around him. That is called innocence. You believe in everything. Ignorance is something that you know, but you're not so careful about it. You're just like that, thinking that everything is good. But innocence is something that is inbuilt. You tend to see everything in a positive way. That is innocence. Like the Kamala Hassan from Guna movie. Ignorance is something that I would say Kamala Hassan from Virupandi movie. He knows everything, and he still keeping himself as a arrogant guy, not believing anything that is told by people. He kept on moving with his own attitude, ignorant to the actual character of people. Hope I answered that.
Yeah, that's it.
Ari, I see a guest joining. Can we wait and give them a topic?
Yeah.
Satish Isaac joined.
Okay, we can have some more topics, Ari. Can you have it?
Yeah, I can have.
Ah, Lakshmi Narayanan. We got 3 guests. Whoever gets connected first will get the topic.
Hello, Satish, Isaac, and Lakshmi. We are on TT now. We have our table topic master Aditi and presenting the session topics to people.
Hello, hello, ji. Hello, Aditi.
Hello, Lakshmi is joined.
Yeah. Hi, guys. Hi, everyone.
Yeah, hi.
Lakshmi, you can share your faces to the audience, maybe.
Yes, so I'm surely not in beach, so just a minute, I'll just.
Okay, Satish is also in. Come on, welcome, Adi. Welcome, Lakshmi. Nice to see you here.
Thank you.
So we have a surprise element for you. Now we are going to give you a TT topic. You have to speak on it.
Okay.
Go ahead, Adi.
Yeah.
Think of him and give a
topic. Paul?
Lakshmi Narayan. Lakshmi Narayan.
Yeah. If you are having the lifespan for 40 years,
if you are having lifespan for 40 years, okay.
Only for 40 years.
Okay.
What are all the things you want to do, and what are all the things you will do?
Okay. Can you repeat it once more?
Repeat it, Adi.
Yeah, if you are having only lifespan of 40 years, what are all the things you will do and what are all the things you will try to do?
Thank you so much, Table Topic Master. So the first thing which I would do is I'd go back to my 8th standard, and I had a crush on somebody. So I thought probably since I had a lot of time left, I thought I would never convey it. So I'd convey my crush to all the four crushes, and after conveying that, I think I'll go, or after the 12th, I'll not join engineering. So I'll avoid joining engineering, and then I'll start going around the world, like how our president Mike is in the beach now. So probably I'll go to beach. Host has muted me also. So I'll not mute anybody when they're attending their table topics if I had to die just in the full 40 years. And then I'll probably join Toastmasters even more earlier, even more when I was 18 years old, and probably I'll just get a lot of experience, get a lot of new friends, good friends, like people from SpeakMagic, and yeah, get married soon. I'll get married when I'm probably 14 or 15. So yeah, so that's it. Over to the table topic. Is the time done? Where is the timer?
1 minute 26 seconds. Sorry, shown my mobile, right? Okay.
Pass
the timer. Okay. Pass.
Thank you so much for the opportunity. Yeah.
Satish Isaac and somebody else join. I don't know what happened. I think we can move because I don't think these two are getting connected. Karthik. Someone, Karthik, join.
Karthik is our
member. Our Karthik join. Probably you can give him a topic.
Sorry, I'm late for some meeting. I got stuck outside. Right.
That's fine. The punishment for you is you got to talk on a topic. Table topics.
Okay. Not supposed to go out.
Adi, give him a topic.
Wait a minute.
Shall I give a topic for you?
When you close your eyes, what do you see? When you close your eyes, what do you see?
Okay, so thank you, Table Topic Master, for a wonderful topic. Which when I close my eyes, I see a lot of things like my vision. Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. So lot of things I see when I close my eyes, like a very peaceful world, very beautiful things like a mountain, animals, and lot of natural things. Not a regular thing what we see. Like after the, for example, after the pandemic, we see like lot of changes. We went for the old days, like not having like lot of communication and all. So lot of travel has been reduced. So those things I see when I close my eyes. Thank you.
Thank you. Next, anyone? That's it, right? Hello? Hello?
Adi, I think we can move. There is no one else.
Yeah. Yeah.
We can move to the next segment.
Yeah. So the table topic session comes to an end. By saying this, I hand over the stage to Toastmaster Michael Dinesh. Toastmaster Michael.
Thank you, Toastmaster Adityan. It was really a wonderful session. It was. There are cases where, like, in TT, the speaker will have to speak ad hoc. Today, I saw a different thing where TTM master prepared topics in ad hoc way. That was really a great attempt. Adi, I
more
really
questions today. Ad hoc.
Okay, guys. And today, I came across a book written by Atushya Deshpande, To the Land of Snow. So this book was written when she was traveling to a glacier called Miller. So what does she face? While she was traveling to a glacier, like an Himalaya, she was held up in a cave. She says like she was held up in a cave, which is hit by a huge storm of hails and winds. And how did she manage to do that? So today we are all in a circumstance where we are hit by a disaster and a catastrophe like Corona. So what should we do? I would say we have three things to do. First thing is there any atheist here? Any atheist? One atheist, okay. So we should surrender ourselves to God or nature. Okay. Another thing is, you should strengthen your relationship within yourself. And you have to strengthen your relationship with your fellow beings. So, first thing, how are you going to strengthen your relationship with nature or God? So, this world and this earth has been so much grateful to us. We get food from here. We get a very beautiful life. So, have we ever been thankful to it? Have we ever been grateful to it? It's time for us to be grateful to it. And next, relationship within yourself. So do we really, how many of you are longing to have some personal time for you? I'm fed up with family, I'm fed up with works, but I still need some time for me, right? We have to self-evaluate ourselves. We need to self-regenerate ourselves and rejoice it. Only when you are happy, you can make your fellow beings happy, right? So it's time for that. And next thing, the relationship with your fellow beings. So I spoke with one of my clients in US yesterday. She was saying that the toilet papers, which was sent for $2, has been hiked to $15. Ladies and gentlemen, this is not a time for us to make money. We have to care for our fellow beings. If you can really do some help for your fellow beings, I'm not sure if there is going to be a crisis for food or water or something is going to happen across. But if you can really help your fellow beings, please do help. And other biggest help is you should not move out of home. That will really help them out, right? So that is with these three things, we can make a really a better better move with this catastrophic moment. Let's move on to the third part of our Toastmaster meeting, that is the live wire or the live blade of our any Toastmasters meeting. We have evaluation session. To have the evaluation session presented by our general evaluator, let's call our Toastmaster Selvaraj. Over to you, Selvaraj.
Yeah. Thanks so much, Toastmaster Maika, for a wonderful session. of wonderful introduction. And let us move on to the evaluation session. Okay, let us first have evaluation for prepared speeches. We have only one prepared speech today by Toastmaster Tamil Ilakkiya, and we have a wonderful evaluator, Toastmaster Satish Ganapati, who was the contestant in the last division level contest held last week. And please welcome him to give an evaluation for Tamil Ilakkiya's speech. Over to Toastmaster Satish Ganapati.
Thank you, Toastmaster Silva. You are all able to hear me properly. Very clear, audible.
Satish, your voice
is not audible. We are not able to hear you properly.
Come closer to your system.
I think I will. How is it now?
It's better.
So let me start my evaluation. So this speech is about selling a product. That is a very essential skill that we all need to possess, regardless whether you are in a marketing or do your any other profession. Because even to sell an idea, they call it as a selling skill. So Toastmaster Tamil has demonstrated how to sell a particular concept or a particular article, in this case, a book. So how she started her speech? Do you remember? A series of questions. Do you want to be a public speaker, or are you in a relationship? Do you want to, lots of rhetorical questions, and then she went on her speech. That was one of her best point, to start asking questions and then leading into the speech. And also she used props. The one prop that she used, one or a couple of props, I would say. One is the book that she was selling, that she used to demonstrate the product itself, because people have to see what they are going to buy. So that was a good thing. And also, there was also some surprise element to it. Some of you might have been surprised when she told, you know, that speech I did, this speech I did, you know, all these were part of this plan. People may not have known earlier. This might have come as a surprise why she was compelled to make a speech because of this manner. So that was a good thing. And also you mentioned about the benefits or the rewards of getting this book. You showed the advanced communicator bronze. Are you able to hear me?
Yes, yes. I'm able to follow you. Yes.
The benefits, the reward that you may get by purchasing this book was also very well demonstrated. That was all good. And in the end, there was a call for action, whether you will buy it and the price of it and what you will get out of it. So all these things were brilliantly presented. Now, in terms of how it could have been done better, right? So there was one point, I was actually carefully following the speech from the start. So there was those rhetorical questions. And then you switched into your past, the past 5 years into the Toastmasters. And after 10 speeches, you got stuck. And then you couldn't use any anecdote or story to develop a speech. And all these times, I was looking for a grasp. So what is it going to be about? So you opened a speech about something related to public speaking. And I was expecting something related to public speaking. It was not quite clear, at least until the fifth minute of the speech, that the speech was entirely about a specific book. If the context is very clear at the beginning, right, people would have, it would have been easy to follow right away from the beginning itself. It felt pretty hard. For me, it was pretty hard to get into the context. So take note how to glide through the topic. Maybe you could have introduced some cue about storytelling at the beginning of the speech itself, and then you can slowly move into your topic. The transition wise, probably that requires some. Other than that, it was a well-presented topic. There was a lot of interaction, even takes. They were all good. Sometimes when you asked a question, I was thinking, probably you could have set a time limit for answering. Okay? For example, take a few seconds and then this question. Some of the responses were too long. Maybe you could have, that could have eaten up more of your own time. Okay? That also you take a note of. So otherwise, the presentation was beautiful. It was really a sales speech, inspiring enough for us all to buy the product. All the best future speech. Thank you.
Thanks, Satish. Thank you, Satish. Thanks so much, Satish. Let's move on to the next tag report. Timer report. Can we have a timer report from Toastmaster Ramesh?
Good evening, once again, fellow Toastmasters. Prepared speech, Toastmaster Tamil Ilakya spoken for 14 minutes, 14 seconds. In table topics, Toastmaster Balasundar, 1 minute, 30 seconds. Toastmaster Michael, 2 minutes. Toastmaster Vidrar, 1 minute. Toastmaster Anandraj, 50 seconds. Toastmaster Ramya, 1 minute, 10 seconds. Toastmaster Selvaraj, 1 minute, 20 seconds. Toastmaster Tamil, 1 minute, 20 seconds. Toastmaster Lakshminarayanan, 1 minute, 26 seconds. Toastmaster Karthik, 1 minute, 12 seconds. The evaluation, it's a mini prepared speech, I think. Toastmaster Sadish spoken for 4 minutes, 51 seconds. Thank you, and over to you, General Evaluator Selvaraj.
Thanks, thanks, Toastmaster Ramesh, for your timer report. Let's please welcome Ananda Raj for our counter report.
Good evening,
Toastmaster. Go to Ananda Raj. Yeah.
Good evening, Toastmaster, again. Now, I would like to provide my report for the R counter. Toastmaster Tamil, she has used two times of R and one times like in the prepared speech. Toastmaster Bala has used one time R. Toastmaster Michael used one time R and one time Toastmaster Selva has used one time R. Toastmaster Vidra has used one time of R. Toastmaster Ramesh has used one time of R. And myself, I have used one time R. Toastmaster Lakshminarayan has used one time R and so one time. Toastmaster Karthik has used two times of R and one time of like. Toastmaster Satish, for the evaluation, he has used two times of R. So that's all from my side for the counter report. Over to Toastmaster Selva for G of the day.
Ramesh, you did a wonderful job as SAA, and then you know, presiding officer on Adityan, he did a wonderful job, excellent, kudos for him. And our president PM Modi, he did a very good job, amazing, great. And our speaker Tamil Ilakya, Toastmaster Tamil Ilakya, she did a wonderful job, and as a storytelling, and she shared the importance of that storytelling, and then she also took us back to the long old days. She was referring to Guna and then Virumandi during a table topic speech, and then Guna while talking on prepared speech. Great, we had a wonderful speech, and the role players, they did a wonderful thing today, especially the timer and our counter, they did a wonderful job. And our the great important thing is, you know, the very amazing thing is the long lot of questions today. Table topics was very awesome. And the table topic speakers, they did a very wonderful job. And let us all appreciate everyone. There are a lot of learnings from all the speakers. I enjoyed a lot. And unfortunately, we did not have a grammarian today. And the word of the day, casetrope, is only used by TMOD. Apart from others, they did not use. And let me quickly go through my report. Nothing can deteriorate even at a catastrophic situation like a coronavirus. Nothing can stop. Where there is a will, there is a way. We had a wonderful online meeting. This is the first time we are doing. I feel it was a successful one. I hope you all enjoyed it. And we do have a member from other club, Toastmaster Lakshmi.
Silva, we can't hear you, Silva.
So you're on mute.
Okay. We do add a member from other club as well today joining us in our team meeting. In our meeting today, he is none other than Toastmaster Lakshmi, who is the contestant in the division level. Last week we had great to have a good experience from them as well. So overall, I see this meeting is really wonderful one, and everyone has connected from different parts of city, but we did not have any technical glitches, and we have done a wonderful job. I appreciate all the role players, all the participants, all the guests, and overall the meeting was awesome. Thanks so much. Over to presiding officer. Over to TMOD Toastmaster Mike.
Mike, you have to unmute. Michael? Michael? I think he lost the connection.
No, I think we lost Mike.
We have Mike, and that mic is different.
And someone take care of the throne. The time already it's half past 7.
Adi.
Kamal, yeah.
Adi is
can
the
you
presiding
take
officer.
Up,
yeah, Adi,
presiding
conclude.
Officer.
Over to presiding officer. Presiding officer is on mute.
Yeah, can you hear me?
Yes, now.
Yeah, I hope we had a great meeting today. The online meeting was very wonderful. And the enthusiasm was in everyone's faces. The corona is spreading over the Tamil Nadu. Please be careful. Don't go outside, don't eat outside foods, be inside the house, spend time with your family and be safe. Let us beat corona and we will be safe, and hope we will have a meeting in our venue soon. With all this, be safe and be precautious. With all your presence, I adjourn the meeting of 76.
Feedback. Please get feedback from the guest. From Ramya,
guest,
Lakshmi.
Yeah, guest from Chennai, articulators.
Mm-hmm.
Lakshmi,
no,
please share your feedback.
I'm not really a guest, so I feel like coming back home, like after so long. It was just one meeting that I had with you. Sorry?
Membership, please.
Yeah. So probably we can have a membership with this also. VP, please contact me.
What happened? Am I audible to anybody?
So it's so good to be back. So yeah, seeing you guys after a long time, so it's really good. Nice to see all the energetic topics. It was really good topics.
Any other guest? Satish, I said. He left.
So we had two or three kids popping up.
Ramya.
Yeah. How was the day, Ramya? How was the meeting?
It was really nice.
We couldn't see you, Ramya. Just low in R. Yeah. Yes. Yes, go ahead. Your voice is not audible. Your voice is not audible.
Yes. Are you able to hear me?
Yes.
The meeting was great and I really enjoyed it. That's it.
Yeah. That's it, right? Any guest?
That's all, we are done.
No guest.
Let us all appreciate the effort from Adi, Tamil Ilakkiya, and Maika to arrange for an online meeting. But this was the first time and they would have done a lot of pre-work for this. Let us all please appreciate that. It is all good effort from Adi, Tamil, and me. Thanks so much.
Okay. Yeah, Lakshmi Narayan want to speak something, it seems.
It is not Lakshmi Narayan, it's Michael.
Okay, yes, Mike.
I have some announcements to make. Okay, let me update it shortly. So we have some targets, okay? So first thing is the outdoor team meeting has been updated. Outdoor meeting and team meeting has been updated. And we have to update TMI about a speak of with the project success communication team. So last week we had Hemant Krishna doing it. So we updated that also. Only thing pending in our plate right now is the joint meeting, which I'm working hand on hand with Lakshmi Narayanan and CAA, Vijay Articulators Club, Vijay. So we'll let you know about the joint meeting very soon. And with respect to the educational accomplishments, we got some feedbacks from VPE. So looks like he had targets for Silva, Ramesh, and to complete the level 1 before the mark. So we urge you to finish that. And please utilize more of your time for Toastmasters since you are locked up now at home and no travel, nothing. So make use of it. We are ready to accommodate as many number of speech possible. And if you need again any slots in other clubs also, please contact our Tamil Rakya. If you want to speak in other clubs, maybe you can contact her. So that's all, I'm good. So make your membership renewal fast. So you can send it to Tamil Rakya through phone pay and everything. So most of them, I think like we have 10 or 11 members have renewed so far. So that was really a great thing. I really appreciate your spirit and that makes me really, really energetic. And I think like we are doing somewhat better, not somewhat better, we are doing really better. That is the only feel that I got by looking at your membership renewals at very fast rate. So happy for it. Anything Adi you want to add as a VPE? No, I think Adi got dropped. Okay. So anybody wants to say anything, add upon anything? And we had our division conference last week. So Satish and Joe participated in it. So my wishes to Satish and Joe. I hope like it was just a miss. It was a
you
great
can, You can wish Lakshmi Narayan also is a winner.
Yeah. Yeah, I understand. That is your part. Pa. I am very much worried about my club. So my best wishes are always with Lakshmi. Okay. So he was SMTC again runner up. So congrats, Lakshmi. You have a long way to go in Toastmasters. Hope you'll enjoy it. And looking forward to much of achievements from you. Keep visiting our club.
Yeah, sure, bro. So I'm looking forward to
speaker, share your inputs to our team members also, how to be such a great speaker. So your inputs are really more.
So to all of your information, I would like to add one more point. So I know you guys are congratulating me, but the script was very much edited by our very own Tamil Ilakya. So I went to a lot of clubs, gave a lot of speeches, and one club, Tamil Ilakya, was my evaluator. So she came there, she totally changed my script. So it was one of the main reasons that I won. So kudos to Tamil Ilakya. Akka, na pesana kekliya?
Yeah, kekudu. Thank you very much.
And other thing is like again to VP member, VP PR again. So today I had posted this meeting somewhere. Many people have started querying me like about your Zoom links, please give it. So I think the Zoom meetings will become much more hit. So it needs bigger advertisements and promotions. Let's concentrate on that. So next meeting onwards, we'll try to pull in more crowd. So that way like we can have more audience and a new flowing into our club. So that was one more suggestion which I got today. And if you are active in Facebook, please do go ahead and like our post. We are telecasting it, all the minutes and everything, we are telecasting it live in Facebook. So please do like our page, like our post, share it. So that will get some good feedbacks to our clubs. Are we good?
Yes. Over to presiding officer.
Toastmaster Adi, where is the gavel?
Yeah, gavel. Yeah, this, be safe with Corona. And I adjourn the 76th meeting of SpeakMagic Toastmasters.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye.
Bye-bye, everyone.
Bye.
Bye-bye.